enots engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video we take another look at the pedestal drill quill. This one somebody's had a go at recutting the Morse taper in the end and it didn't quite work, so I'm having to set this up and try and recut the Morse taper to save it. And on the end of this is a brass water pipe fitting which has been used to hold the Jacob's chuck into the quill. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. This is the quill out of a pedestal drill. We have some problems with the Morse taper in the end. The chuck keeps falling out. So what the first thing I want to do is put it between centres. I'll set the dial indicator up on this end and you can see there at zero, that's a thou. This is where the bearing locates. This is where the other bearing locates. So we'll come down to this one. And we'll see how much this runs out. There's a thou at this end as well. So the two bearings locate there and they're both running a thou out to the centres, so it's not bent. There is an interesting way that they've tried to hold the chuck on this one to stop it coming out. It's quite a good idea really. These are just a couple of water pipe fittings, and what they've done is on the inside of this one they've machined the bore so this will fit onto the end of the drill quill, so that goes on like that, and then you can tap this over until the face comes up to the face inside, so you have a thread on the end. This is the arbor for the Jacob's chuck that goes on here. They've got the other part, put a washer inside, this goes over, that goes in there, and then when this is pressed down they have the thread on the end and they can tighten this up so it holds the chuck in position. But the first thing to do is check, why does the chuck keep coming out? And I think we've got the answer here. You put the taper in there. If I look at that, you can see this spindle is only being held on half of it. This end's clear. So this gives the chuck wobble, so it'll wobble inside like that because it's only being held at the bottom. Now the first thing I need to do is get the taper in here correct for the number two Morse taper. I'll need to set this up in a steady and maybe hold it to this end on the chuck and get the two running true. I've held the quill three-jaw chuck, and on the other end it's in the centre in the tailstock, so I know the other end's running within a thou because it's picked up the centre. This end I want to adjust it to run to zero. It's running out thou and a half. This chuck I can alter, I can offset it. So I'll get the lowest point, and on the chuck I have three screws I can adjust. And when I get the lowest point, I adjust the screw that's near the lowest point, and what that does, it pulls the chuck over. So you can adjust it within a tenth. I think it's a little, move along a bit just in case there's a high spot on that. I'm not going to try and get it any better than a tenth. You can see it's in the centre on this end, so now I need to take the tailstock off, locate a fixed steady onto this and get this running zero, then I'm ready to machine the bore to the correct taper. You can see it's running out about half a thou, but that's because of the finished. I move it backwards there, look it. Depends where you take it on here. That's running out there. Tooth out. So where the steady's touching, it's about half a thou. So now I'm ready to set up for the bore. To try and true up the bore. Let's have a look what it's running out down here. I'll have to turn the dial indicator over to quite an angle to get that in. So the bore's running out 2 thou. Now to set the compound slide to the correct angle, what I'm doing is taking the number one Morse taper sleeve. I'm just holding it in the end of another number one Morse taper sleeve that's in the quill and the centre in the tailstock. I've moved my compound slide about just over 1 degree. So all I have to do now is get my compound slide to run down that at roughly zero. So that is within a couple of tenths of a known number two Morse taper. So that is roughly set up. That's another number one Morse taper. And all I was doing was using that to locate the end of that one in there to give me a centre point. And this one has got a female centre in the end. And I put a male centre into tailstock so that could hold between centres just to set the angle correct. Now I'm not going to rely on the angle. What I'm going to do is use a known number one Morse taper, something like that, without the tang on the end. Put some micrometer blue on there and check the taper as I'm machining it. Got a matching taper. I've put some micrometer blue on and I'm just holding it on the end with a carrier so I can twist it into the bore. What I'm concerned about is whoever's machined this bore, the back is bigger than the front, so by the time I get the taper right, it might break through here. No, it's bottomed out on the bottom of the taper, so I need to open the bore up at the far end. Okay, what's happened on this? The bore has been bored out, and as this here goes in, it hits the bottom of the taper. And even with a tanged end, the tang width here is hitting the end of the taper. So I think whoever bored this out before maybe did the bore but didn't open up the bottom to let the tang in to its right position. So what I'm doing, I'm just taking some more out of the diameter here so the tang can move further up. This is one with the tang on. Yeah, that goes down further and locks up. This one hasn't got a tang on, but I'm using it to check the taper. You see there, it's gone right down. A standard taper will lock in there just about. And all I've done on this is true the taper up the bit that was there, and on this end opened up the bore a bit. I'm not going to take any more out because I'm worried here the thickness of the outside of the tube along this edge is thin. There's still some play in that. I don't think you're going to get that out on that. Just take a little more out the end. I'm going to leave it at that because I think that's better than it was. Take too much out, this end's just going to snap off. So this was the original Jacob's chuck goes on here. That goes right in now. Where before it was about there. So I think that might be okay. At least now it locks in, it's not wobbling. This is how the clamping arrangement works on a taper. This is the taper you want to hold in. Your Jacob shut goes on the end. And what they've done is put a washer on here and one of these water connectors. And the Jacob's chuck still fits on here. Then when you put the other end, the other part of the connector on the end of your drill quill, when you put the two together, you can tighten the nut down on the quill. It stops the drill coming out. So if you've got a bad fitting Morse taper or any vibration and your chuck comes out, this will hold the chuck in, but it won't fall down onto your workpiece or your table. It's just a simple couple of water pipe fittings and a washer. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was interesting, hope it's useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.